Julie never gave in. The twins of destiny keep smiling when the friends are so far away. When the foes are waiting and watching, Jules and Julie never give in. The twins of destiny keep fighting.
The chief eunuch, Po Dung, eventually accepts his offer. She is to be paid to spy upon Martin Garson, who is waiting impatiently for news of Jules and Julie. The twins themselves, still on the way to Marseille, are with Sabatier, heading towards a magician's conference in Lyon. T-Ben discovers by chance that they are bound for Lyon. That evening, visiting the quayside there, he recruits a few villains. In the forest, Jules and Julie are taking a walk before going to sleep. There's a full moon that night, and with the animals of the forest looking on, they use their power. In a dream, in the imperial palace of the Empress of China, they see and hear their real fathers as statues, as well as Captain Tournier, who gives them encouragement and urges them to continue their journey.
Forget. Look out for the boy or the girl, alone or together. They may attempt to board the boat separately, or even to sail on two entirely different boats. Believe me, they are far from stupid.
Don't worry, if they come this way, we'll see them.
At 500 francs each, you can bet we'll be cleverer than them.
The 500 francs you've been given so far are nothing compared to what you'll get if you capture them.
Say 5,000 francs each, that'd be plenty of cash for a good while. Hey, you better make sure you don't lose him.
Stop worrying, it'll be dead easy.
Gaspard and I will go to the Convention of Magicians now to see if we can find them anywhere there. Whatever you do, don't forget what I said. Don't let them join hands if you do see them.
Okay, we'll remember that. Don't know about him, but I will. A power which comes out of their hands. That ought to go down pretty well at the magic show, I reckon.
You just do as I tell you, or I'll get someone else.
Hey, keep your hair on. He was just having a little joke.
There's nothing to joke about. You've no idea what the Twins of Destiny are like. I have followed them all the way from Paris, and they will slip past you if you don't obey my orders.
All right, we get it. We'll do as you say. Isn't that right, boys?
Yeah, for 500 francs, I'd build a wall between them with my own hands to keep them apart.
All right, we'll be on our way.
He didn't have to shake me like that, though.
Go on, just do like T-Ben said. It's his money. We'll have to obey him if we want it.
5,000 francs for just a couple of kids? That Chinese guy's gotta be nuts or something.
Perhaps he is, but if he's paying...
Sabatier.
Thank you, Lee.
You have surpassed yourself again this year, Sabatier.
Ah, but you're too kind, Paul.
The special effects at the end of your show were sensational. Wherever could you have found such a dazzling idea?
Let's just say I was inspired by something I saw this week.
However, friends, we three are not the only magicians here today. Jules and Julie, would you be so kind as to show these gentlemen what you have been learning?
But, Sabatier, we've only just learned how to do the tricks.
We all have to start somewhere, Jules. Even the pretty good Sabatier had to start somewhere. So please, I'd like to see what you have learned.
Well, I learned, sir, that your wife's first name is Annette.
Amazing, but how did you know that?
very easy. On the back of your watch, there's an inscription. To my dear Leon, with all my love, Annette.
Wonderful! That's simply wonderful! But how or when on earth could you have got hold of my watch, Jules?
A good magician never gives away his secrets, does he?
Ha 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 ha! And Julie, what trick are you going to do for us?
The question is, what are you going to do for me? Oh, thank you, sir. They're very pretty. You're too kind.
Ha 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 ha! Be very careful what you say to them, Sabatier, or else one day these children will be wanting to take our jobs.
Speaking of taking, sir, I need one more flower. I think you may be hiding something in your coat pocket which belongs to me, if you care to look.
Perhaps I ought to make certain that I still have my wallet in my pocket.
Well, we ought to go now. The boat won't wait. Come on.
Pleased to have met both of you. See you again someday.
And keep up the good work you do.
I do wish we could have stayed until the public opening tomorrow, Mr. Pretty Good Sabatier.
So do I, Julie, but you've already sent a telegram to your friend down in Marseille, and all the other boats will be full up by now. So there's not a moment to lose.
We're both going to miss you, Sabatier.
And I shall miss you too, children. I've lived for so long with only old Corbeau for company. Oh, of course, I am glad to have met you both, but I am very sad you have to go now.
That's the third time we've been around the fairground. If they were here, we'd have seen them by now, wouldn't we, T-Ban?
There's a good chance they haven't arrived in Lyon yet.
Hey, look!
It's them, I'm sure of it.
5,000 francs.
No shooting, you fool! Are you trying to tell all the police in town what we're doing?
So what do we do then?
We simply follow them and wait for a good moment to strike.
Why are we going this way? Isn't your cart on the other side of the field?
Don't turn round, children. We're being followed.
It must be the eunuchs.
Don't turn round. We must try and lose them. Corbeau and the cart are waiting behind this tent. We'll go in and go out again through the back, and we'll have escaped. I am the Pretty Good Sabatier, and I know this tent is not yet open to the public, but I wanted to... I was hoping my young friends would be able to have a quick peek inside.
Go in if you like, but don't touch anything.
Looks like they're running for it.
Perfect! I can get the children on their own and finish them off.
What do I do?
Go and find the magician's cart. That way, if they do get past me, you can simply block their escape. Did you see enough of them to remember what they look like? Although I don't think they'll be making it as far as the cart anyway. Listen, my good man.
Yeah, what do you want?
I want to take a quick look inside the tent.
Yeah, you don't look like much of a magician to me.
I am a Chinese magician.
How about showing me a trick, then?
With one wave of my wand, my money will change into your money.
Now that's the sort of magic I like.
And now, if you're satisfied, let me go in there so I can look around.
Be my guest, sir.
Thank you.
Do you think they'll try to follow us in here?
Yes, I'm sure they will.
We ought to find plenty of surprises in here now. I'm sure we can lose them.
This time, one without the other is no good to anyone. Huh? A mirror. Huh? What a gun! Huh? How can I find them with these stupid mirrors?
You know, we could have had more fun in here if we didn't have a unit chasing us.
Come on, don't slow down. Almost there. Come on, the exit can't be far from here. Ha-ha, we found the exit.
Look, there's the car.
We won't make it. He's right behind us.
Unless we can stop him from getting out of the building. Julie. I think that ought to slow him down a little.
There I was trying to teach you magic.
I don't think it'll keep him very long, though.
I've got a funny feeling about this.
Come on now. No time to waste. With a bit of luck, you'll be on the boat to Marseille.
Sorry, it looks like your luck's run out. I'm the lucky one instead. That's close enough, you two. And don't even think of touching hands. I've got all three of you covered. You two keep well apart. T-Ben told me all about your power.
Oh, let them go. These two children haven't done you any harm, have they?
Perhaps not, but soon enough they're gonna do me a lot of good. 5,000 francs, in fact.
That's nothing compared to the price of these diamonds.
Oh, yeah, and who might you be?
Someone who wants to get their hands on the children even more than the Chinaman.
Stop there, that's close enough. Diamonds, you say? But how am I to know they're real ones?
See for yourself.
Give them here, and nice and slow, get it? Oh, they're spiders!
The old diamonds and spiders trick, just like the old days.
It still works all right, don't you think?
It works perfectly, Leon. And now we'll have to be on our way, I'm afraid. Can you take care of them?
Of course. I'll take this charming fellow off to the police.
We ought to let the police know about T-Ben, too.
Oh, no, the police will ask lots of questions, and we don't have time.
Sabatier, do you think you could drive us down to the harbor now?
Very well, then, Julie.
Thank you for all your help, sir.
I would do almost anything to help the pretty good Sabatier. Come on, you. You'll need more than magic to keep you out of jail.
Let's go, Kobo. Come on, old boys. Do your stumps. Off we go.
It's me, Martin.
He isn't home. I'm sorry, I seem to have frightened you, Paulette.
Oh, no, no, not at all, Shalcow.
Is something wrong?
Oh, no, it's all right. I just wanted to find out where Martin had got to, that's all.
He went down to the telegraph office to see if there has been any message from the twins yet. You don't seem very happy.
Me? I feel fine.
No, that isn't true. It seems as though you're afraid of me for some reason.
Oh, no, no, I'm not.
Then what is it?
You know very well what it is. Why are you doing this? I thought you were my friend.
But, Paulette, if my presence in this house bothers you, you only have...
Bothers me? That's a good one, that is.
Paulette, are you there?
Oh, it's Martin.
I've had news from the twins.
I'll see you later. And you can tell those friends of yours I will do exactly as they told me.
What friends? I am sure I will never really understand women.
So where's Shao Kao?
In the next room. I wasn't sure you'd be here or I'd have asked him to wait for you.
I got a telegram from the twins. They're in Lyon. They're taking a boat down to Marseille today.
This is marvelous news, Martin. That means they're sure to be here in 2 days at the most.
Paulette, isn't that great? In just a couple of days, we'll be on the boat on our way to China.
Yes, yes, of course. I'm very happy.
I don't understand. You don't look it.
So what am I supposed to do? Jump in the air for joy, maybe?
I believe it must be my presence in this house which upsets her.
No, Shao Kao.
It doesn't matter now. In a couple of days, you will be on your way.
At last, the news we have been waiting for. The twins leave Lyon today for Marseille. So they will be here in a couple of days, noble master.
Then in a couple of days, they will be dead.
What are your orders, Po Dong?
Nothing for the moment. We simply wait until the twins have actually arrived at the house next door. Then my plan will come into action. We will simply destroy the entire house and all those in it.
They're following right behind us. Please hurry up.
But how do you know that?
We just know. It's true. Please, you have to believe us.
After what I saw at the fair, I think I'd believe anything you told me. Aha, we're almost at the river. Come on, Kobo!
We're in danger, and I can feel it around us. Sabatia, you must stop this cart now.
What you just said?
Please stop the cart now. It's too late, Jules. Look.
There they are! They're all ours now. Stop right where you are!
Go! Go! Look out, Edmund! They're trying to make a run for it!
Don't worry, I'm not gonna let 5,000 francs go that easily.
Go! Corbeau! Corbeau! Corbeau!
Jules, we have to try and save Kobo. The power. Quickly, let me take your hand, Julie. Let's hide behind the boxes.
What about the old man?
Forget him. We only need the kids.
Come on, you kids. We aren't going to hurt you. Show yourselves. Stupid kids, come out of there right away or else. Just stay calm and it'll be all right. I almost got the girl, Edmund.
I've had enough of playing games now. After all, T-Ben said dead or alive.
You killed Corbeau, my best friend, and I'm going to make you pay.
That knife won't be any use to you, magician.
My poor old Corbeau. Shh, good boy. Shh, good boy, Corbeau.
Quick, get the boy first!
Police! Quick! Police, this way!
Look out, the police! Let's get out of here!
We better take him with us and get him seen to.
So where are the police?
Nowhere. I just shouted police to frighten them. It's an old magician's trick.
It looks like it worked.
So is Corbeau?
Yes, poor old Corbeau's dead. I know it's stupid to cry over a dumb animal.
Corbeau wasn't dumb. He was very clever. I loved him as much as you did.
It just saved my life, you know. He pulled the card over the eunuch's hand to stop him from picking up his axe to kill me. He'll be different without you, poor old Corbeau. You were a good friend to me. Rest in peace wherever you are now. Goodbye. I'll take you down to the harbor. You'd better leave quickly before they come back.
Sabatier will miss Corbeau.
I'll miss him too, Jules. I'm going to be lonely.
Having boarded the boat, can Jules and Julie now manage to get to Marseille without running into further trouble? And even if they can, the eunuchs there have both Martin and Shao Kao under constant watch. Don't miss the next episode of The Twins of Destiny.
When the world is no longer fun, when the stars are no longer shining, Jules and Julie never give in. The twins of destiny keep smiling, making a stand for their homeland. When the world is no longer fun, when the stars are no longer shining, Jules and Julie never give in. The twins are dead.